Just took a bit longer to find my way home, chapter 11, tipping point. Maddie enjoyed days off like this, a cup of tea in hand, the sun slowly rising, the house quiet. All was well. Tom had already left for work, meaning it was just her and Sonic for the day. She was sure the two of them could find something fun to do together. But he hadn't woken up yet, which was understandable. It was only a little after 8 in the morning. So she busied herself with reading. An hour went by and he still hadn't come out. By the time 10 rolled around, she was getting a little worried. She was about to go check on him when he trudged out of his room, right as she was bookmarking her plates in her book.
Morning, sleepyhead. Did you sleep well?
He glanced her way and Maddie felt her heart twist painfully. He looked exhausted. Maybe it was just her, but it looked like he had been crying. Concern ate away at her.
You okay?
Sonic only silently nodded. Well, that only made her worry more.
You want anything for breakfast? You craving anything?
Sonic shrugged. Maddie stood up and walked to the kitchen. Sonic silently followed after her. She looked in the pantry and the fridge.
We have cereal, eggs. I can make you a smoothie or some toast. Whatever you want.
Sonic didn't answer.
Sonic?
She asked, turning around to face him.
Toast is fine.
Maddie didn't want to push. She really didn't. But this was concerning. She grabbed the bread and put it into the toaster. With nothing else to do but wait for the bread to finish toasting, she leaned against the counter and offered the hedgehog a small smile.
Didn't sleep well?
Sonic didn't look up to meet her eyes. He continued to trace a circle with his finger along the countertop.
More or less.
Nightmare?
That got a reaction out of him. He froze. It was a blink and you'll miss it moment, but she noticed. Sonic shrugged.
No, just couldn't sleep. Maybe I'm just still not used to sleeping in bed.
It was a weak excuse and they both knew it, but she didn't want to push it any further. However, whether he wanted to talk about it or not, she was still going to stay by his side and provide whatever comfort he needed. With his toast finished, she grabbed the slices from the toaster and placed them on a plate.
Do you want anything on your toast?
Sonic nodded.
Anything you want in particular?
Surprise me.
Maddie opened the fridge and grabbed some cream cheese and strawberry jam before applying a generous helping to both slices. She then placed the plate in front of Sonic. Sonic glanced at the plate in front of him, his face scrunched up in curious confusion. He grabbed a slice and sniffed it before taking a bite. His eyes widened.
Glad you like it.
Thanks.
Sonic said with a small smile. Maddie ruffled the quills on his head.
Of course.
She walked over to the cabinets, going to get him a drink. What she didn't notice was the way he shrunk in on himself, a conflicted and pained look in his eyes.
You want anything to drink?
She asked, taking a cup out of the cabinet.
Water is fine.
Maddie filled the cup with water from the fridge before placing it in front of him. He paused in eating and took a sip.
So, anything you want to do today?
I think I'm gonna head back to bed. I'm really tired.
That concern that had been resting in the back of her mind came back and clawed away at her again.
All right, I'll wake you up for lunch, okay?
Sonic nodded and finished eating before heading back to his room. Maddie just knew something else was bothering the kid. But she wanted to give him a bit of space. She would respect his boundaries. After all, it wasn't like he was her kid. So, Maddie began to do a few chores while he slept. Doing the laundry, putting away the dishes in the dishwasher, folding clothes, and so on. At around lunchtime, she went to check on Sonic. She approached his door, but she heard him talking to himself inside. She quietly approached and listened in.
You knew you weren't going to stay forever. Can't I just be a bit selfish for once in my life? The last time you were selfish, you got the one person who cared about you killed.
Maddie frowned. His talking had ceased. She gently knocked on the door.
Sonic?
It was silent.
You want some lunch?
I'm fine.
Are you sure you don't want something?
I'm sure.
Maddie's frown deepened. Something was wrong. She walked back into the kitchen and made him a sandwich. She walked back over to his room and placed the plate on the floor and knocked.
I made some lunch for you if you want it. I left it on the floor in front of your door. I would get it unless you want Ozzy to get it.
There was no reply. Maddie sighed and walked back out into the living room and sat down, not sure what to do. Ozzy approached and laid his head on her knees. Maddie sighed and gently scratched behind his ears.
I don't know, buddy. He won't talk to me.
She heard the door to his room open and shut. Maddie couldn't help but smile to herself just a bit. Even if he didn't open up, she was still going to be there if he needed someone. Sonic didn't get better. In fact, he stayed in his room more and more. It was concerning to both Tom and Maddie. Had they done something wrong? Was something bothering him? They didn't know. It was a little after 7:30 one night. Sonic hadn't come down for dinner again. Tom had a plate in hand. He glanced at Maddie nervously. She was just as nervous and worried as he was. They didn't know how to go about this. They might not be his parents, but they cared for him, and they were going to help him through whatever was upsetting him. Tom gently knocked on the door.
Sonic?
Leave me alone, please.
Sonic, what's wrong?
Nothing's wrong.
Maddie and Tom exchanged glances once more.
Hun, what's ever bothering you, we can try and work it out, okay? You haven't been yourself these past few days. Is it something we did?
No. No, you guys are perfect.
Then what is it, Sonic?
Tom asked, becoming a bit desperate for the hedgehog to open up.
Nothing. Can you guys just leave, please?
Maddie placed a hand on Tom's shoulder. He sighed.
All right, just talk to us when you're ready, okay?
They got no response. Tom placed the plate he had been holding down on the floor.
We also brought you dinner. It's right outside your door if you want it.
And they both left. Inside the room, Sonic was desperately trying to wipe away his tears. He should have left. He needed to leave. He was only causing trouble and stressing out the two humans. The quicker he was gone, the better it would be. But as he looked at the red shoes sitting by the door, he couldn't help but feel a dull pain begin to throb in his chest. He could stay for one more night. Sonic hopped off the bed and quietly opened the door. He looked down and saw the dinner Tom had mentioned leaving for him. His eyes stung with tears again. He grabbed the plate and quietly took it into his room to eat. After he finished, tired from crying, he turned off the lamp on the bedside table and buried himself under the covers, falling asleep quickly. However, sleep came and went, like sand slipping through his fingers. He would get an hour of sleep before waking up again, staring at the ceiling for a good while before finally going back to sleep. Each time he closed his eyes, sharp medical tools were cutting him open. A familiar doctor laughed, finding joy in cutting him open and experimenting and learning.
You truly are something special, Hedgehog.
The doctor would always say after discovering something new about him. And sleep seemed to get further and further away. Finally, around 3:30 in the morning, he was tired enough to fall asleep once more. But he wasn't even granted peace then. His eyes moved fiercely underneath his eyelids. He tossed and turned, quietly crying out in pain, as if wounds being inflicted upon him in his dreams were real. His cries of distress, pain, and fear grew louder as the minutes ticked by. And then the first blue spark jumped from one quill to another, and then another, until his room was illuminated in electric blue. Sonic shot up with a scream, tears rolling down his cheeks. He didn't notice the lightning. He didn't notice the tears rolling down his face in fat droplets. He didn't hear Maddie and Tom run into his room frantically asking what was wrong. Nor did he notice their shock and slightly terrified faces as they stared at his glowing quills. He finally came to when he felt hands gently grab his. Sonic sucked in a deep breath and could hear Tom and Maddie's voices.
That's it. In and out.
There you go, baby. It's all right.
Sonic's breathing began to slow, and the bloom had gone away. He looked into Tom and Maddie's eyes. how they were filled with compassion, concern, and love.
It's okay, Sonic,
Tom whispered, and Sonic then threw himself at the man, sobbing into his shirt. He sobbed out incomprehensible apologies, in other words he couldn't even understand. Tom gently shushed the kid in his arms and ran a hand through the hedgehog's quills. Maddie continued to rub gentle circles into his hand.
I think it's time we talked, yeah?
Sonic nodded.